Sharks have existed in one form or another for millions of years. Just when you thought it was safe to go back in the water, it was never safe. It has never been safe. Hey there, Street Sharks. Trace here for DNews. Sharks are truly ancient. There's some disagreement on when they actually appeared on the scene, but any way you slice it, they were here almost 200 million years before the first dinosaurs. It's pretty impressive that we can trace their ancestry back that far when you consider that sharks have skeletons made of cartilage, not bone, which inherently doesn't fossilize as often because it's easier to break down. In fact, the earliest evidence of sharks is from just a handful of scales found in Colorado that date back 455 million years. These scales have a characteristic tooth-like structure to them that makes us reasonably certain that they were once stuck on something we could classify as a shark. The earliest undisputed shark scales are 420 million years old and were found in Serbia. But aside from their scales, we have no idea what early sharks looked like. When you hear shark, your first thought is probably of a torpedo-shaped super predator with rows of awesome teeth like steak knives, but millions of years ago, their shape could have been something that we wouldn't recognize. It's the definition of what makes a shark, that allows for a lot of that flexibility. Sharks must have replaceable teeth, internal fertilization, paired fins, the aforementioned cartilaginous skeletons, and distinct scales, and of course, jaws. So when the fossil record starts becoming richer around the Devonian period 400 million years ago, sharks of all shapes and sizes started popping up. We've found shark teeth that are two-pronged, like the rock-on symbol, suggesting that they had to eat their prey whole instead of ripping chunks out of them like they do today. Early shark bodies may have even been more eel-shaped with long, tapering tails. Even when they began looking more familiar, they were still pretty different. They tended to have long jaws that were at the front of their heads, and they couldn't extend them to catch prey like modern sharks. There were actually two major adaptive radiations where shark diversity just exploded. The first was during the Carboniferous period, starting 360 million years ago. Mass die-offs of competitors meant that sharks could thrive, and in particular, one group, the stethocanthids, really pushed the envelope of style. One stethocanthus species had an anvil on its back, and nobody's quite sure what advantage that gave it. Maybe it was waiting for the hammerhead to evolve so they could fashion swords together and create an unstoppable shark army. Probably not, though. Another shark, the Helicoprion, appears to have had a buzzsaw-shaped lower jaw, but of course, we don't see these guys around today. At the end of the Permian 250 million years ago, 99% of marine species died out, including most sharks. Some made it through to the other side, though, possibly by sticking to deeper seas where the water was less acidic. These sharks were minuscule, only like an inch long, but they would be the start of something big. By the Jurassic period, 42 million years later, they would cause the second adaptive radiation of sharks, leading to modern sharks as we know them today. Sharks have survived through five mass extinctions because they've taken on so many different forms and filled so many different niches. But today, their populations are dwindling. The rate we catch sharks, either intentionally or as bycatch, is devastating for species with a low reproductive rate. And sometimes we intentionally slaughter sharks in the name of protecting swimmers near coastlines. In the last 450 million years, sharks have seen a lot, but never anything like humans, and many species might not last much longer. If you want to learn more about what sharks have become, tune into Shark Week, which kicks off Sunday, June 26th at 8, 7 Central. Do you want to know what you can do to stave off shark extinction? Because there are some things. Tara has a video on that here.
Overfishing is a huge problem globally, and in the past couple decades alone, the demand for sharks has gone way up. People hunt them for their meat, fins, cartilage, liver, skin, and teeth, and they often die in brutal, inhumane ways.
Would you rather swim with one 10-foot-long sharks or 1,200 1-inch-long sharks? Let me know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching.